Hey everyone, welcome to the psychology lecture series. In this video, we are going to talk about survey method in research. The term survey can be defined as a process which may involve an investigation, examination, or assessment in the form of a short paper and pencil feedback form to an intensive one-on-one in-depth interview. With the help of the questionnaire or other statistical tools, the method ties together data about people, their thoughts, and behaviors. Interviews are different from questionnaires as they involve social interaction. Unlike questionnaires, researchers need training in how to interview. Researchers can ask different types of questions, which in turn generate different types of data. For example, closed questions provide people with a fixed set of responses, whereas open questions allow people to express what they think in their own words. The interviewer must ensure that they take special care when interviewing vulnerable groups such as children. For example, children have a limited attention span, and for this reason, lengthy interviews should be avoided. Also, the language the interviewer uses should be appropriate to the vocabulary of the group of people being studied. For example, the researcher must change the language of questions to match the social background of their age, educational level, social class, ethnicity, etc. Interviews take many forms, some very formal and others more structured. A structured interview is also known as a formal interview. This is like a job interview where the questions are asked in a set that is standardized order, and the interviewer will not deviate from the interview schedule or probe beyond the answer received. Structured interviews are easy to replicate as a fixed set of closed questions are used. They are quick to conduct, which means that many interviews can take place within a short amount of time. Structured interviews are not flexible as new questions cannot be asked. The answers from structured interviews lack detail as closed questions only generate quantitative data. Unstructured interview, sometimes referred to as discovery interview, are more like a guided conversation than a strict structured interview. These are called informal interviews. It has open-ended questions and they can be asked in any order. Unstructured interviews are more flexible and the interview can deviate from the interview schedule. Unstructured interviews generate qualitative data, and this allows them to talk in some depth choosing their own words. It is time consuming and is quite expensive to employ and train interviewers. For example, certain skills may be needed for the interviewer. These include the ability to establish rapport and knowing when to probe. In the group interview, the role of the interviewer is to make sure the group interact with each other and do not drift off topic. Group interviews also generate qualitative data through the use of open questions. Group interviews are less reliable as they use open questions and may deviate from the interview schedule, making them difficult to repeat. Group interviews may sometimes lack validity as participants may lie to impress the other group members. They may conform to peer pressure and give false answers. The design of the interview should be based on gender and age, personal characteristics, and ethnicity. For example, if a researcher was investigating sexism among males, it is possible that if a female interviewer was used, male participants may lie to impress the interview, thus creating an interviewer effect. The second element required for a survey is an instrument to collect data. A questionnaire is a basic tool of survey research as it can be used to meet the needs of almost any inquiry. They can be carried out face to face by telephone, computer, or even by post. Questionnaires provide a relatively cheap, quick, and efficient way of obtaining large amounts of information from a large sample of people. It's an efficient way to get large amounts of information from a large sample of people. This is particularly useful for large populations when interviews would be impractical. However, a problem with questionnaire is that they may lie due to social desirability. Often, a questionnaire uses both open and closed questions to collect data, so that both quantitative and qualitative data can be obtained. Closed questions structure the answer by responses which would fit into pre-decided categories. The categories can be restricted to as few as two options. That is, for example, yes or no, or male or female type of options. This is called nominal data. Closed questions can also provide ordinal data. For example, strongly agree, agree, neutral, disagree, strongly disagree, or unable to answer. This can be used to measure the strength of attitudes or emotions. This can be economical, and information can be easily converted into quantitative data. These type of questions lack detail. As the responses are fixed, there is less hope for us to get people to reflect their true feelings on a topic. Open questions allow people to express what they think in their own words. Open-ended questions enables them to answer in detail. For example, can you tell me how happy you feel right now? If you want to gather more in-depth answers, then open questions will work better. Open questions are often used for complex questions that cannot be answered in a few simple categories. Rich qualitative data is obtained as we get elaborate answers, but it's time-consuming to collect and analyze data and is also not suitable for less educated respondents. I hope you like this video. Please share these videos with everyone who is preparing for this exam. Thank you.